brake bleed at Cayuga going into turn two, and suddenly just realized that I had no pedal left and the car was barely slowed down. Yeah. People, I know we're always tempted to have power, more power, more power, more power. But if you can't stop, you're gonna end up in a tree, and all that power is wasted. Next thing I got, proper snow tires on 16-inch wheels. I know, high profile sucks, but it doesn't suck in the case of having a narrow snow tire, which gets through the snow, sinks into the snow, and has enough cushion to soak up the bumps. I am happy with my 16-inch wheels right now, and I love it.
Thank you.
expecting too much from what is just a ball of bar at the front of the car. The cart boy short shifter and the shifter bus shifts. That's probably one of the best mods I've done so far, because it definitely cleaned up the shifts and made it a lot more predictable and just a lot better in general. Better feel, more sporty feeling, more immersion when you're driving. I recommend it to everybody who owns a WRX. Change your shifter bushings. The steering rack bushings are the same way. Change your steering rack bushings. But I would certainly put the money towards the shifter bushings even before the steering rack bushings. You'd be surprised about the difference the shifter bushings and steering rack bushings and all the bushings can actually make them. Definitely something to research and something to consider if you want to have an immersive, fun drive. Try to make your car respond the way you want it to. Make your shifter behave the way you want it to. Make your steering wheel respond the way you want it to. Make your steering wheel feel the way you want it to. Those are the types of models. that is what I'm planning with the WRX. Make it a nice, firm, but not harsh ride. With nice bushings and everything to make it more enjoyable. Without ruining the ride. Everywhere. No, I've never driven one with manual gearbox. All owned automatic, it seems. There's nothing to do except arrive at your destination with your signals. I still recommend everybody. signals, but that's all you're doing when you're driving the Corolla. There's nothing engaging about it. So, number one best thing to do, get a car that you enjoy driving, that gives you tasks. Maybe you want to downshift while a heel toe downshifted while braking into the on ramp on your way to work. Go for it. No one's going to stop you. If the police try to stop you, it's only because they're jealous of how awesome you are, okay? It's not illegal to heel toe downshift, and you can tell them that. But I don't think any police officer even would. They're going to listen and they're going to think, wow, I should be doing that. But the government gave me automatic. promise it wasn't me. My bumper that was more damaged than the damn cat. Maybe a raccoon, I didn't see, but it's some small black and white critter. Just jumped out of a ditch that I was going down a road, and it was going well below the speed limit. It was dark, it was coming up to a stop sign, I didn't want to go quickly, I was going like 30 or 40, maybe 50 kilometers an hour max. Because I was approaching a stop sign, especially. And jumped the cat out of the ditch, and I went to swerve to avoid it, didn't swerve in time, flipped the cat just a little bit, and it was enough that it damaged the wheel well liner, the fender liner, if you will. Keeps all of the mud from ending up in your engine bay. The cat broke that. I went back to find the cat and one of the brake ducts was missing. I found it. No sign of the cat. Very good. being raced in when you're 2 inches away from the guy in front of you, and he brakes and you would hit him, and your bumper comes flying off and you have to buy a new bumper. That's the thing that gives you incentive to drive well, in my opinion, is having the experience at the track and so on. You obviously want to drive according to the conditions. You can have a little bit of fun still, even below the speed limit, if you go to a place where there's not enough traction, and you kind of just have fun with it that way, but you have to drive according to the conditions, and even if you're sideways, you're still having fun, but responsibly, because you're going below the speed limit.